respectfully ask that you silence, or better yet, turn off your phones, and please refrain from any flash photography for the duration of the service. Thank you. Friends, we are gathered in the sight of God to witness and to bless the joining together of Jan Ingmire and William Schweiker in Christian marriage. The covenant of marriage was established by God, who decided at the beginning of time that it was not good for us to be alone, but that we should have a partner who would journey through life with us, loving us and supporting us, walking by our side. Jan and William have found that life partner and constant companion in one another. With his presence and his power, Jesus graced a wedding at Cana of Galilee, and in his sacrificial love gave us the example for how we are to live together with one another in love. Jan and William, come now to give themselves to one another in this holy covenant.
You may be seated. Jan and Bill, I ask you now in the presence of God and these who are gathered to declare your intention to enter into union with each other through the grace of Jesus Christ, who calls you into union with himself, as acknowledged in your baptism. Jan, will you have Bill to be your husband, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love him? comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live. The answer is, I will.
I will.
William Schweiker, will you have Jen Ingmire to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
This question is to all the rest of you. Will all of you, by God's grace, do everything in your power to uphold and care for Jan and Bill in their marriage? And the answer is, we will.
We will.
A reading from the Epistle to the Romans. Let love be genuine. Hate what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Do not lag in zeal. Be ardent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in suffering, persevere in prayer, and live in harmony with one another.
Thank you.
reading from the Song of Songs. Set me as a seal upon your heart, as a seal upon your arm. For love is stronger than death, and passion is fierce as the grave. Its flashes are flashes of fire, like a raging flame. Many waters cannot quench love, neither can floods drown it. If one offered for love all the wealth of his house, it would be utterly scorned.
This is a day of new beginnings. Time to remember and move on. Time to believe what love is bringing, laying to rest the pain that's gone. The poem of Brian Wren that we sang at the beginning of the service, A Day of New Beginnings. And what a joy it is for all of us to be here in a place that you call home, Jen and Bill, the sanctuary in the center of the city, to celebrate your new beginning. Now, there's something important to notice about Brian Wren's poems, hundreds of which have been sent to music. He's realistic. He tells us to leave behind the pain of former days, the disappointment, guilt, and grieving, and move on to a world of difference that faith and hope are renewing within us. Brian has been a guest here at the Chicago Temple a few times, leading workshops and preaching. And it's his embrace of being human that makes his vision of the future powerful. Christ is alive and goes before us to show and share what love can do. This is a day of new beginnings. Our God is making all things new. And that's true not only for the two of you, Bill and Jim, but for all of us. I mean, here's your extended family. About 200 people in your home celebrating your new life. And it's never too late to be born again, as the saying goes. And to think that all of this started with a French lesson over 4 decades ago. Now, Bill had to pass a French reading exam as a new PhD student at the Divinity School at the University of Chicago. And my wife, Sally, had been a French teacher. I was serving at campus ministry at the university, and I'd met Bill at the Div School. So he started coming over to our home on Blackstone Avenue to learn French, which he did sufficiently enough to pass the test. And Bill and I became friends, along with Robin Lovin, we being the Methodist Trinity. And Bill and I stayed connected through the years of study and teaching and writing while I served congregations in the Chicago area. And then when I was appointed to be the lead minister here at the Chicago Temple, I saw that Bill had begun attending Sunday morning worship. He was always about two-thirds of the way back on the west side of the sanctuary, sometimes with his son Paul, other times with special guests, international colleagues that he had invited. Perhaps Bill came here on Sundays so that he did not have to apologize to them. The music, the liturgy, the architecture, all made for a good morning at his home church. Now Bill is officially the theologian in residence here at home. Jan, I became friends with immediately when I started my ministry here, out of necessity, because she ran the church. I mean, she was chair of the church council, always a compelling voice at every table where decisions were being made, leading visionary for the renovation of the sanctuary, a firm advocate for the start of an international theater company, the Silk Road Rising, and a board member and TV host of the Greater Chicago Broadcast Ministries. And all of that while she kept a job as media consultant, most notably with the Journal of the American Medical Association, and also with hospitals and universities. But she was mostly obvious and present here at the temple in the soprano section of the choir. Every Sunday morning at 11 o'clock, every Christmas Eve, at the Interfaith Thanksgiving Service on Wednesday in November, at the Indigent Memorial Service on Wednesday in May, and then the Good Friday Service that started at noon and ended at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. This has been Jan's home church for years, and she has made so many others feel at home here. So Bill was sitting out there two-thirds of the way back on the west side, and Jan was sitting up here in the choir loft just behind the pulpit. And one Sunday, after the service, Bill stopped to talk to me, and he said, "Phil, who is that blonde woman in the soprano section who looks so alert and sings so energetically?" And I said, "Well, I think, Bill, you're talking about Jan Ingmire." Then on another Sunday, very soon afterward, Jan stopped me in the hallway and said, "Phil, there's this rather distinguished-looking man sitting about two-thirds of the way back on the left side most Sundays, sometimes with a younger person, occasionally with two or three guests. Do you know who he is?" "Oh," I said, "I think you're talking about Bill Schweiker." Now, I've often wondered what people are thinking while I'm preaching. Now I know. And then very soon afterward, they're both at O'Hare Field, and they're hurrying to catch separate flights, and they see each other, and they nod in recognition. And then, over the years, Jen and Bill, you can fill in those "and thens" as you wish, but here they are on this blessed day of new beginnings. And I think it all started with a French lesson. I mean, isn't God wonderful? Bill and Jan, you both found a home here at this church, and then you found each other. And today you're surrounded by an extended family, a family not only defined by genetics or geography, but by love. I mean, you could actually turn around and look for a moment and would not be see who these people are. Most of them you invited. Most of them have embraced you with their love over all these years. Here are people who knew you when you were young in Des Moines and Joliet, and when you were students in Carbondale and Chicago, and when you took your first job and your second, when you succeeded, when you failed, when you were sick, when you were discouraged, when you were elated, and now you are finding a new life together. And here is a community in which love is genuine, to use Paul's word to the Romans, a love that rejoices in hope, is patient in suffering, and perseveres through it all. We will stand by your side we all say by being here, with a daring spirit, as Brian Wren calls it, with a love stronger than death, we read in the Song of Songs, a fierce passion that cannot be defeated. So, Bill and Jen, you are not the only ones making vows today. All of us join you with one voice to renew our commitment to you. So now, where is this day of new beginnings going to lead us? Jen, you're going to continue to organizing the world around us. You've done it in medical settings, in universities, business offices, and certainly the church. So where can we go with you now? And might there be a way of spending more time with you away from the office? Maybe at a table outside at a cafe on a nice autumn day for a cup of coffee? And Bill, you still have time to figure out how morality makes us human. Theological humanism creates a base that is much larger than provided by any religious tradition, any philosophical system, any individual insight. So where do you think you're going to be able to think out loud about these things? Maybe it's a good thing that you have maintained your connection with the University of Chicago. A great description of the UC was given by Martin Gardner, 1936, graduate who went on to write popular articles about mathematics, science, religion, skepticism, magic, fables, and Alice in Wonderland. He said, "The University of Chicago is a Baptist institution where atheistic professors teach Jewish students about St. Thomas Aquinas." Sounds like the perfect place for you to discover precisely what makes us human. And what about the rest of us here today? What new beginnings are going to be revealed to us because we're here? I mean, how might we become more human, to become more fully alive, to more confidently say yes to life? How do we who have been called into community of love today by Jan and Bill share the communion of God's love beyond here and now? Brian Wren's poem ends where the collection of biblical texts ends, here with Revelation chapter 21, God's declaration, "Behold, I make all things new." That's the gift that God calls us to embrace as we embrace the two of you. Let us pray. Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation, giver of all grace, bless and sanctify with your Holy Spirit Jan and Bill, who come now to join in marriage. Grant that they may give their vows to each other in the strength of your steadfast love. Enable them to grow in love and peace with you and with one another all their days, that they may reach out in concern and service to the world. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Repeat after me, Jan. I, Jan.
I, Jan.
Take you, Bill.
Take you, Bill.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Bill, repeat after me. I, Bill.
I, Bill.
Take you, Jan.
Take you, Jan.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted in death.
Until we are parted in death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
At this time, I'd like to invite all to stand who are able for the... to watch the exchange of rings.
These rings are the outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to all the uniting of Jan Ingmire and William Schweiker in holy marriage. William Schweiker, so you kindly say line by line, Jan Ingmire, I give you this ring.
Jan Ingmire, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Dear Jan, you kindly say line by line, William Schweiker, I give you this ring.
William Schweiker, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
While you all are standing, I invite you to sing number 384, Love Divine, All Loves Itself.
Thank you.
seated. Bill and Jan, you have declared your consent and vows before God and this congregation. May God confirm your covenant and fill you both with grace. I invite you to turn to the congregation. Now that Bill and Jan have given themselves to each other by solemn vows with the joining of hands and the giving of and receiving of rings, I announce to you that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Bill, you may salute your bride.
So consecrated the covenant of Christian marriage, that in it is represented the covenant between Christ and his church. Send therefore your blessing upon William Schweiker and Jan Ingmire, so that they may surely keep their marriage covenant and so grow in love and godliness together, that their home may be a haven of blessing. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
It is right and a joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. You have made from one every nation and people to live on all the face of the earth. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. He commissioned us to be his witnesses to the ends of the earth and to make disciples of all nations. And today his family in all the world is joining at his holy table. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took the bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us, as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is alive. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. Renew our communion with your church throughout the world and strengthen it in every nation and among every people to witness faithfully in your name. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory, and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. And now, with the confidence of the children of God, let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Friends, you will be invited to the table. You'll be led through the center aisle, and you will be given the opportunity to either take communion through intinction, where a piece of bread will be given to you to dip lightly into the cup of juice. And for those of you who are gluten-free, there are gluten-free options on the east and the west sides of the sanctuary. And we encourage those of you who do not choose to take my intinction to use that form as well. Let us be served.
Let us pray. Eternal God, we give you thanks
for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves to others. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Jan and William, God the Eternal, whose essence is love, keep you in love with each other so that the peace of Christ may abide in your hearts and in your homes. Go to serve God and your neighbor in all that you do. And to all gathered here, bear witness to the love of God in this world, so that those to whom love is a stranger will find in you kind, generous, and loving friends. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all this day and forever. Amen.